Howdy, mister. Excuse me, a bit more space, please. Why are you being so rude? I ain't afraid to stand up to you. How dare you?
I don't know, but I hope, either way, good, bad, or plain indifferent, after all she...
Bon, bon, bon.
I hear young Pushhare's son does not have his father's eyes.
C'est scandaleux.
You can look over the meeting from some vantage point. Remember, this is not just the man who killed my husband.
Who killed my husband?
Your husband? That little milksot? I guess I imagine he was your brother. No woman would ever marry his kind. Oh. I did kill him. I did it. And he was begging for his life. Pathetic, really.
Who put you up to it? Who?
Lady, that's none of your damn business.
some bitch.
Thank you.
not shoot anyone,
put that
okay?
Gun down.
Ah, you go.
Well, that, all right.
That'd be first.
Myself.
Who's talking now, huh?
Damn it all!
I think I had
enough.
There's
going to be trouble.
I need a bed.
We can still live free. We can still say we don't recognize you or answer to your laws. Better to be one man living the truth than a million living a lie. Let me tell you something. Now, you all know that most of us old-timers, we fought alongside each other. 3rd Lemoyne Regiment. The summer of 62, we was hunkered down by Copperhead Landing for weeks. It was a terrible time. It was terrible. Food was rotten. Humidity was unbearable. Nothing we had ever got dry. But we knew that sooner or later the enemy would be coming down the line of Hachi if they wanted to take Saint Denis. And sure enough, one morning, we woke to the distant sound, the boom of a cannon. And next thing you know, there's grenades raining down on us, modified artillery shells, leave a man with the most horrific wounds. That's like nothing you ever seen. And then I get blown up into the air, and I'm as high as a house. And then everything goes black. Then I come to in a cloud of smoke. I think I must be at the gates of hell. And then it clears. And I see a swarm of them damn blue bellies. They're not 20 feet from me. And I ain't got no rifle. I ain't got no gun. I ain't got no nothing. So I just turn and I run at them. And they raise their rifles and they fire, but it don't make no sound. Their powder was too damn. So I get in there and I take them with my fist one by one until I know they're dead. And I just walk out of there as calm as the night. Something's only lost if you let it be. And as far as I can tell, you're all still breathing. Even though you're a bunch of lifeless saps. So buck the hell up! You hear me?